We do a lot of tech stories on this newscast, and many of them have real-world implications when it comes to your pocketbook, your health, your family's future. But sometimes the greatest thing about technology stories is simply the technology itself, the stuff that our grandparents read about in books and that our parents watched on the Jetsons is now becoming reality. NRS correspondent Michele Greenstein has been looking into some of these. In fact, she's walking onto the set right now. Come on out, Michele. I'm curious to hear what you're going to be able to report on this based on the fact that we see these all the time, and they have that oh, wow effect, right? It's like we look at them and go, oh, my God, is that really a robot? And these are the kinds of things that you're looking into for us today. What'd you find?
So firstly, as you probably know, yesterday the first ever robotic moon lander took off. This is an unmanned spacecraft. It's named Bereshit, which is the Hebrew word for Genesis. Mm-hmm. Let's take a look at this. It's the first ever privately financed mission to the moon, by the way. And like I said, it lifted off yesterday from Florida. There it is right there. This is a robot that will try and land on the moon's surface. It's going to take some pictures, conduct some experiments, and we'll have to see what it brings back.
Robotic lunar landing device.
Exactly.
Okay.
No crew on board. So the next robot I want to show you, this is really crazy. This is the Antbot. It has six legs, and it will navigate terrain without any GPS. Of course, creators say that this kind of technology will reduce the risks of navigation where there is no GPS. Now, here's what's really interesting. Take a look at that. It's inspired by desert ants. So usually ants will find their way back home using pheromone trails,
right.
But in the desert, the heat of the ground actually destroys their pheromone trail. So desert ants are, you know, able to do this just by using the sun's rays itself.
So
in the same way, this robot was inspired by those desert ants by using polarized light.
So they're using real things to make the fake things. All right, number three.
Exactly, inspired by nature. So that was the Antbot. Now let me show you the Plantbot. This just came out. It's actually inspired by plant tendrils, again inspired by nature. This is a robot that's able to climb and curb around plants. And creators say that it could inspire the development of wearable devices that, you know, could be barely detectable. Mm-hmm. And possible applications also include the development of flexible robotic arms, which of course brings me to my next robot, the robotic arm. Now, here's what's crazy about this one.
Okay,
this
I'm ready.
Robot is self-aware. Look at it picking that stuff up. This is a machine that's able to adapt to its experiences. So what the creators say is that in the same way that humans take in their experience, they imagine themselves and think about their future, the self-awareness of this robot will do the same exact thing.
I don't understand what you mean by self-awareness.
So it basically takes in all the information. Let's say it tries to pick something up and it fails. It knows that a red ball is not there anymore.
Oh,
so in this way, it becomes more resilient to whatever comes its way in the future. Exactly.
Yeah.
Self-learning.
Uh-huh.
Now, it's impossible to conduct any sort of discussion about the development of robots without mentioning Boston Dynamics. Let's take a look at this next robot. Last year, this totally blew up the internet. This yellow robot that's very dog-like. This one happens to be named Spot Mini. It's one of their many animal-like robots. And this one, creators say, funnily enough, that, A, it can fit comfortably in your home or your office, hence the name Spot Mini. It's entirely electric. It can actually go about an hour and a half without a charge. And
say it ain't so. They're actually going to put dogs out of business. I mean, my poor Cha-Cha will
not
no longer be necessary.
It can let you out of a small space, as seen here.
It's good stuff. I mean, you can't not look at
that.
Gotta
love science.
You can't not look at it. All right. I'm Rick Sanchez. You found us on YouTube, and that's awesome. But you know what? I'm also live every night at 7 and 8 p.m. Eastern on DirecTV and Dish and cable and satellite, the RT app. Oh, and Pluto TV. I'll see you there.